Okay, now what we want to do is make some variations of our page to track. So I'm just gonna copy the sales page here. And then I'll rename this. It doesn't really matter what you call them, but I'm just gonna call it index 2. And then I'll make index 3. Now the idea is that you make changes on each of these pages to try and improve the copy to achieve your goal, whether your goal is a sale or an opt-in or whatever it is. Okay, so what I'm going to do, I'm just going to open each of these and I'm just going to put version 2, version 3. So when we're going through the test to make sure it's loading up the pages, we can see that it is. Okay, so I'm just going to open this up with a web editor called Composer, which is free. Let's open. And index 2. And we'll also open index 3. And I'll just put here, just so we can tell. Now, of course, like I said, you're going to want to make some changes so you can see how your conversions change. Okay, so I'm just going to say version 3. Then we'll save. And here we'll say version 2. And we'll save. Okay, so I'm going to upload these to the server as well. Okay, now what we need to do is set up our conversion tracking. We want to test when something converts. And by conversion, in this case, we mean that they hit the download page. So let's go over to standard reporting here. And then on the left side, you'll see conversions. Just roll this up here. And we have goal URLs here. So we have to set up the goals. Okay, you'll see now that we're in the admin side where we're going to set up our goals. So our first goal, and we're going to call this a sale. And for this, it's going to be a URL destination. Now there are many different kinds of goals to set up. I'm not going to go over all of the different goals because there's a lot of them. The specifics, what we're going over in this video is how to do an A/B split test and see which page is converting the best. So what we want to know, what we want to do is when the download page is hit, if you were doing a squeeze page, you'd have the thank you page or whatever. Well, that's the URL destination. So what we're going to do here is put the goal URL, which is our download page. Okay, so here it is. This is the download page. So I'm going to copy the URL from the top here and I'm going to paste it in here. Okay, then you have match type here. This is going to be an exact match because that's exactly what where we're going here, since this is a URL. You also have head match and regular expression match. And then whether it's case sensitive or not. Okay, now under goal value here, this is the amount of the sale in this case. So we'd put 27.00. So that would be a $27 sale. This is optional if you're tracking conversions for a squeeze page and you wouldn't put anything in there. Then we have a goal funnel where we can track the different pages leading up to this page as well if we want, but I'm not going to use goal funnel here, so we'll just save that. And there is our URL destination setup. Now we can set up more goals if we want, but that'll do for now. I'm just going to set up the one goal. Now we're going to set up our experiments. So let's go over to standard reporting here. On the left side now, we go into content, and then we go down to experiments. This is where we're going to start setting up our split testing. So enter the URL for the page you want to improve. And so this is our main sales page that's going to go in here. Okay, so this is our main page. Put that up here. Okay, so there you see that it is now shown us what page it's found there. That's our first page. So now what we're going to do is click Start. So let's give this a name for our experiment. Now, okay, so this is our control, our original page. We've already got that in there, and we can give it a different page name in there if we want. Now, oh, we'll down a little too far there. So variation one, we put in the URL to our next page. So I'm just going to copy this down because it's the same. And then it's slash index2.html. Now we can give it a name. I'm just going to leave it as variation one. Now we can add another variation. And then I'm just going to copy this one and it's index3.html. Okay, and that's variation two. So you can keep on doing that for however many pages you want to test. Now the good thing is that it goes through and it tests all these pages against all the other pages. Okay, so now what we're going to do is click Save and Next. Okay, now what we need to do is select our objective, which is the goal we just set up. So there is our goal. Next, you have the percent of new visitors that you want as subject to the experiment. So if you leave it at 100%, everybody that comes in is going to get filtered through the experiment. I'm not sure why you wouldn't want that at 100%, but you can change it here if you don't want to use it that way. Email notifications, simply if you want an email about changes to the experiment. Okay, here we have some advanced options. Okay, consolidate for content reports and minimum experiment time. What will happen is Google will wait for this amount of time that you pick here before it will pick a winner. So it's going to tell you which one is winning in the conversion race. So you don't have to start testing them against each other. You don't do an A/B, then put another one in the mix and then test the winner against that one and then take the winner out of that and test the winner of another. This is going to do it all at once for you. So pick whichever one you want here. You have 3 days, 1 week, or 2 weeks. And then the confidence level, it has to reach this confidence level before it will declare a winner. Save and next. Okay, now our original page needs some code added to it, and you can either add it yourself or send the experiment code to a webmaster. I'm going to add it myself. And then here is the code, so I'll copy this. Okay, so I need to go and do an open with notepad here again. And then I want to put this code on the page as well. I'll just put it above this code. And then we'll save. Now I need to re-upload the home page here, or the original page that our experiment is starting on. Okay, and that's it. We hit save and next. Now here we go. It's checking our pages. All your pages have working code. Okay, so we know that it is now set up properly. Okay, now it's got a summary of our experiment. So here's how our pages will look. There's the original page. Here is the next page. And if you put your mouse over top of this, it'll show you the whole URL. You see it's index 2. And here is index 3, although it went off the page there. Okay, our goal is completions of a sale, which we set up. We're sending 100% of visitors. We're not consolidating our variations. It's going for 2 weeks, and we want a 95% confidence threshold. Okay, let's run the experiment. Okay, so it's just telling us that it's going to start rotating all of our visitors through because we picked the 100%, and then it's going to start showing the data after it has enough data to show. Okay, and this is your experiments list, and it shows you the details of your experiment. Okay, now we can go and test this out now. This is the original page. So if we do a reload, okay, it's taking us to version 3 on the next visit. Now, let's reload again. Okay, so we know that it's rotating through now. It does have some smarts in it to know when a visitor has hit the page. If you hit refresh, it's not going to take you through the funnel every time you hit refresh. Okay, I just hit reload again. And you'll see that it's staying on version 3. However, if I were to close the browser, let me open up Chrome here. Okay, and I'm going to paste the URL into Chrome. And it took me to version 2. Okay, so as you can see, it is taking us through the experiment here. Okay, and then after it's collected for some time, you'll start seeing the results in here. Okay, so now you know how to set up an A/B test using Google Analytics.